world, and welcome to the Mecca of Mastery TV. I am your host, Mecca. If it is your mission to become the greatest version of yourself in every area of life, then you, my friend, are in the right place. I'm so excited about this episode because in this video, we are speaking about personal and spiritual development. And the topic of this video is how to get your spark for life back. Let's get straight into the video. How to get your spark for life back. I know the frustration, right? When you have been in a space in life where you felt like you were flowing, that childlike energy, where things were just so amazing, where you didn't feel like your day-to-day activities and doings was tasks, right? Right? Where the things that you once had love for that made you shine and smile within, now you just look at them like, I have no energy for you, right? Those things that you used to love doing, waking up, dressing up, making a cup of tea, getting up early, going to the gym, you know, doing your yoga, going to see this friend, talk to these people, going to this place, going to the, like all of these, having that spark for life. First of all, let me tell you something. Before I get into the drip, hold on. Before I get into the soul food, this weekly soul food, okay? This weekly soul food. If you are not a family member here at Mecca Mastery TV, I'm gonna need you to go ahead and make it official and hit that subscribe button. It's now official. You are a family member because trust me, honey, you do not want to miss any updates. This weekly soul food that we drop every Monday. Okay, so here we go, right? Life and that spark, right? We are here to have these human experiences. You are a soulful being. I say this all the time, right? You are a soulful being having a human experience. And you are truly here just for the fun of life. That's what we're here for. We are here for the fun of life, right? For everything fun. And when you're not having fun, that's when you just feeling depressed. Like, what is really going on? So here's what I want you to know first. Just like there are seasons, right, in nature, and this is why nature can be our greatest teacher. Just like there are seasons in nature, these same seasons are within you, your own psyche as a whole. You have a winter phase, you have a fall phase, you have a spring phase, and you have a summer phase. You have every season within you. So sometimes the reason why something that you once had a spark or energy for, okay, and then you don't feel that spark or energy, it does not mean that it's completely lost. It just means that maybe you're in a winter phase, right? So for example, I am a dancer, right? I am a dancer. I run a organization called Confidence Builds and Heals. I'm the founder of that organization, and I love dancing. Now, there are times where I have to teach dance classes once a month in my hometown and other places, but there are times where throughout the year, I don't feel in that creative vibe. Like, and I'll go back and check my choreography and I was like, yeah, I wasn't feeling it. I used to think that this was a bad thing, but I'm realizing that everything has its season. And instead of trying to force it to be something how I want it to be, because I had things be this way all these times, right? Why not just allow myself to flow with the season, allow myself to adapt at that space and time, right? Because here's the thing that I had to learn. Even though, right, we all love that summer phase, spring phase of like our lives, right? When you're creating, when you're bearing fruit, when all of that, that's just not reality. You have to have those moments where everything is still, right? When you're in hibernation mode, that's the winter phase. Sometimes the things that you have sparked for, that is what's going on. You have entered a certain phase within you, right? A season, maybe the winter phase. And so you feel like, I don't feel energized because it's time for you to hibernate. And that doesn't mean that you can't create or do whatever you want to do that's calling you. You just have to switch it up. Like when it's in the wintertime, I am not for example, working out with my intensity, how I am in the summertime, right? Not to say that there are not days in the wintertime where I go to the gym or whatever I'm doing and I'm like hitting it. But I notice when I'm outside in the sun, honey, and I'm feeling good, and it's like that energy from just the summertime, when that is on me, like, and I'm and in me, I can see a difference. Now, here's the other thing. Sometimes you lose a spark for the things that you once had a spark for in your life because you have so many distractions around you. You have people distracting you. You got that device distracting you. You got your thoughts that's eating you up alive, distracting you. And it's taking you away from the very thing that you want to give your energy to the most and your attention to the most. So what do? Eliminate those distractions. Discover what is it that is actually taking you away from the things that you want to give your attention to. What are these distractions? Right? Because once you realize what these distractions are, then you can actually put a plan in place to actually remove them. And another thing I want you to know is this. Everything has this life, death nature. Nothing is just always in a life, like I said, spring, summer phase. It's going to have a moment where it needs to hibernate, where it's like you draw energy back, hold it back, let it sit there for a second. It's breathing, it's gaining more, it's learning more, it's putting more in, and then boom, it comes back out. That's the same thing. So when you are a space in your life and you don't have that spark and that zest for life anymore, first look within yourself and ask yourself, what season are you in energetically? Like, for example, me, honestly, I am in tune, in alignment with the universe, right? Whatever. I'm in a sunny place right now, right? But we are dealing with the fall, winter kind of phase. So I am like, I'm like 50-50 right now. I'm like 50% like spring, because that's what it's feeling like. It ain't feeling like the summer. I'm like 50% spring and 50% like fall, winter vibes, right? And so I create from that space, and I do everything else in my life, in every area of my life around that space. I'm not going to force myself to be given 10 when I'm on a level 7. And I'm not going to feel bad, because nobody is always at 10. If you are at 10 like that, baby, you're a robot. Okay? They need to be charged too, though. They need to be charged too. They need to be charged too. And sometimes if you don't have a spark for life, here's the last point. Sometimes it's just too much that you are focusing on and giving your attention to, so you can't even flow. When you have so many things that you are trying to do and you truly don't have the capacity for all of them, and sometimes we try to do all of this stuff because it's our ego. Our ego be validated. You know how it is. You doing this, you got this accomplishment, you hustling over here, you got this business going on, that business going on, that business going on, and then you got people on the outside saying like, oh, look at you, you a hustler, you know, praising you. Then some people, they be all hooked to that praise, but dying inside. Have no flow, can't feel, can't see, can't really feel the wind on their face, on their arms, can't really have a connection with the sun, not have a conversation with the water flowing, can't have time to just pet a pet. You know what I mean? To pet a pet, okay? To pet a pet, to just sit down and just breathe on the couch. Some people don't have that. And sometimes it's because you are giving your attention and your energy to too many things, and you have to drill it down to one thing in every area of your life. What is the one thing that matters the most? Not you out here when you're working out, trying to work on the physical part of your body. Not you doing CrossFit and you running in the morning and you doing yoga and you doing weightlifting. Plus you're trying to go to dance classes. Then you're going to, it's too much. You got to choose which one, you know, what's going to get what, not at all at the same time. So scale it back sometimes. And I'm going to leave you with this at the end. Less is always more. If you want that spark for your life back, I want you to start reprogramming your mind as well about what you are saying to yourself about life in general. And what does life mean to you? What does it mean to be successful and feel good in life? Get to the core and to the root of things. Some people don't have a spark for life because they focus on all the things that do not matter, right? Look at the beauty of life. Connect with nature. Connect with people. Connect with yourself. Get away from this damn phone all the time. That's how you get your spark back for life. Realizing what your why is. Looking at things deeper than you, things that are more ancient than you, like these trees and the sun, connecting with those things, right? Getting outside of yourself, getting your head up out of your own ass, being somewhere and just doing something nice for somebody else. That gives you your spark back. And then raising your vibration to align with the things in which you wish you had, in which you feel that you have lost spark with. I'll say that again. Raising your vibration to be in alignment with those things in which you feel you have lost the spark in. So for example, when I felt like I had no passion for dance, I started to really think about dance. I started to think about why I respect dance. I started to get deep with dance, like what it does for my body and my spirit. So then I started doing things, just small things. I started listening to music and just dancing with my arms and my hips without going into a full studio. Then I start learning from offline. Then I drop myself into a class. Then I start making up my own choreography. And then voila, girl can't stop moving. Okay? And I wish the same for you, whatever it is that you feel like you have lost that spark with. Okay? And look, if you need guidance in your life and you don't know where to start, I will hold you accountable, hold your hand, and help you create a plan to get you from where you are to where you want to be. I have 1-on-1 spiritual life coaching sessions available virtually via Zoom for 1 hour. If you want to book a session with me, just click the link in the description box below. And also, if you are somewhere in your life where you want to start your spiritual journey and you don't know where to start, I highly recommend my 21-day healing plan. To learn more about that and to grab your copy, click the link in the description box below. And if you are on social media, please stay connected with me on all these other social media platforms. I would love to get to know you at a deeper and personal level because I share so many inspirational, insightful, educational, entertainment things on my social media platforms as well. And if you have any questions for me, just if you got any questions or if you want me to talk about any topics here at Mecca Mastery TV, you can always email me directly at meccabookings@gmail.com. And as we always say here at Mecca Mastery TV, you my friend, my soul friend, you go into the world, you kick a whole lot of action. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't do anything because you can do whatever you put your mind to. I'm sending my love, light, tranquility, good-ass vibes, and high vibrations your way. Until next time, I see you in the next episode with peace and love. Mwah. See you.